asking you a question. Could this be fine? This is the scenario, right? Every parent brings kids. And then they ask, should we use swine flu vaccine? Just a brief background of the swine flu vaccine in India, indications are right. We all know that influenza A infects animals, humans, and birds. Whereas influenza B and C infect only humans. There are several antigens which are there on the surface of the influenza virus. The chief among them are the hemagglutinins and the neuraminidase. There are about 16 types of hemagglutinins. Though only 3 are seen in human, all the 16 are found in the birds, migratory birds, which act as the reservoirs. So, permutation and combination of all these French and M can take place, and we can get a new virus. We always used to say, man thinks, you know, he knows everything, I have 6th sense. Lot of scientists are working on finding out newer vaccines, newer antibiotics. A unicellular organism or even a virus outbeats a billion crore project of a man, and then, you know, it undergoes a mutation. So that is what is called as cosmic intelligence. Cosmic intelligence is there in every living being. We had the regular influenza. If you go through the literature, 1918, the Spanish flu, where, you know, came so many lives. Then in 1997, we were all, you know, worried about bird flu. But fortunately, it was only transferred from sick birds to human. No human to human transmission was reported. Whereas 2009, we had a new hero, swine flu, which is nothing but H1N. See, when we listen to any lecture on influenza, we always come across these terms, you know, drift and shift. Change in the nucleotide series is called drift, and it results in endemics. Whereas complete replacement of one or both of the surface glycoprotein gene is called shift, and that results in pandemics. To quote the 1918 pandemic of Spanish. Now, let us see the background information on H1N1. H1N1 was first reported in March and April in 2 children in the United States. Then it spread to Mexico, Northern America. And by May 2009, you know, these are days, I'm sure all of you will be facing the situation. Somebody is working in a software company. They say, I'm going to the States for the next 3 months, doctor. Take care of my child. I won't be here. You know, the air travel, more than the migratory birds, our airplanes have started carrying infected individuals and resulting in pandemic. So in these days of increased travel from one part of the globe to another part of the globe, it is not a very astonishing thing that the virus, which was detected in March and April 2009, spread to the many areas of the world by May 2009. By June 11, 2009, WHO declared a pandemic of swine flu. And as per the reports of the CDC and WHO, H1N1 is likely to continue as a seasonal virus for some more years to come, along with our regular flu virus, which is H3N. What is the current scenario in India? Though exact mortality morbidity statistics in a country that has a population of 1 million is not available, whatever is available from the reports of the Immunization Committee of the Indian Academy of Pediatrics, I have gathered. The statistics up to 15th August 2010 say that there are 37,395 confirmed cases of swine flu in India, and out of which 9,945 deaths have been reported. Our own health secretary last month has given a statement in the newspaper. Tamil Nadu, from in the months of July, August, September 2010 alone, we have had about 720 confirmed cases, out of which there were 7 deaths. Higher mortality, or highest mortality has been reported in Maharashtra, Gujarat, of course in Kerala also. Next. How does the swine flu or the novel influenza due to H1N1 vary from that seasonal influenza, that is H3N2? One of my favorite professors, when we met, cracked a joke. You know, you meet a thug, it's about 10, 11 o'clock in the night, you're getting in the subway somewhere in Ajinagar on the Mount Road, there are no policemen around, a thug comes and he asks you for your money purse. You happily give your money purse at the watch or whatever bangles if you're a woman and a chain if you're a man, and happily part with it and say bye bye to him and get up. This was the thing with the regular flu virus. It used to affect immunologically deficient individuals. What will happen if you fight against a thug? You will not only lose your purse, watch and chain, you may lose your life also. So that is what is happening with the swine flu. The swine flu is affecting more of younger individuals in the age group. If you see, the incidence of infection is higher in the younger age group, 0.5 to 24 years. And the risk of hospitalization is more. The median age in the Indian scenario is 20. In USA, the median age is reported to be around 37. The increased incidence of hospitalization in children below 4 has been reported. 90% of the deaths in seasonal flu, that is H3N2, was in those above the age of 65. And 60% of the hospitalization in seasonal flu is only in older individuals. Respiratory reserve is very low. Apart from that, we always tend to think in practice, because the route of entry of the virus is respiratory. Any child with a respiratory infection, we think in terms of a flu. But 21% of the H1N1 patients also reported GI symptoms. So I have seen a child with a chronic fever with diarrhea with slight cough turning out to be positive for RT-PCR, turning out to be positive for swine flu. Pregnancy and obesity are supposed to increase the risk of complication and death. If you look at the case fatality ratio, for swine flu it is 0.86%, whereas for an ordinary flu it is 0.13%. I'm sure all of you in this group will agree with me that looking at this statistic, it is not proper to deny immunization to anybody who asks for it. Though WHO says that the pandemic is over and now we are in the post-pandemic phase. What are the influenza vaccines that are available in India at present? One is the live monovalent vaccine, which is only to protect H1N1, which is administered intranasally, prepared by the Serum Institute, which is recommended for use only above the age of 3 years. The other one is trivalent inactivated vaccine containing H1N1, H3N2 and the influenza B, manufactured by different companies like Chiron, Solvay and Sanofi Pasteur, which is recommended for use for anybody above the age of 6 months. The third one is the inactivated H1N1 monovalent vaccine, manufactured by Cytus Canada, which is only recommended for people above the age of 18. So here comes the confusion. You know, in a clinic, not only the time is wasted, the debate goes on. The parent, which is the best doctor? Give my child the best vaccine. Let us analyze. First, who are the people who must be given H1N1 vaccine? Except the last sentence, all the others are WHO recommendation. I just added the last sentence for fun. Can be given to anyone who asks for it. It is criminal if you refuse it. and that gentleman gets the swine flu. Pregnant women, people who care for infants below 6 months of age, health care and emergency medical facility. I would like to know in this audience, how many of you have vaccinated yourself with swine flu vaccine? Can you raise your hands? 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9. Very low number. Please, my sincere request to all of you will be, because we are all caring for sick people. Don't think I have been treating viral illnesses from time immemorial. My immunity is so good, I am not going to get swine flu. Because swine flu seems to like people with a better immunity than those with a weaker immune system. So, health care and emergency medical personnel, anyone from 6 months to 24 years of age, and anyone from 24 to 64 years of age with chronic medical conditions like asthma, diabetes, renal disease, or a weak immune system which may be due to an acquired immune deficiency like AIDS or hereditary hypogammaglobulinemia or other immune deficiencies. Next. Contraindications for the live vaccine which is administered intranasally. Children below 3 years because experience is lacking and they have a immunologically incompetence. Adults above 50 years, pregnancy, immunodeficient individuals, chronic health problems as which we have already mentioned, on long-term aspirin treatment and persons in contact with immunodeficient individuals and Guillain-Barré syndrome. Next. Children who should not be given trivalent inactivated vaccine, age below 6 months, moderate to severe febrile illness, irrespective of the cause, history of hypersensitivity egg, or previous influenza vaccine, or any of the vaccine components like gelatin, amikacin, thiomersal, etc., and past history of Guillain-Barré syndrome. Next. How many doses are being given? Previously unvaccinated children below the age of 9 years should receive 2 doses at 3 to 6 weeks interval. More than 9 years, the current recommendation is 1 dose will be sufficient. We are yet to get data regarding seroconversion, though estimation of neutralizing antibodies to the immunogenes is supposed to be the ideal way of expanding. Because the vaccine is available only for the last 2 to 3 months, we are not yet getting any data regarding the seroconversion. Next year, we may get better data, which may tell us whether we should give only 1 dose in those above 9 years or 2 doses are required. There has been no cross immunity for H1N1 in those who have received H3N2 seasonal influenza vaccine in children. All of you must be clearly aware that the H3N2 vaccine is available for the last 1 decade. So some of our over anxious and over caring and very well meaning parents might have given their children H3N2 vaccine before. But no cross immunity is seen for H1N1 in those children who have received the seasonal influenza vaccine. Studies in the adults have detected cross reacting antibodies to the extent of 6 to 9% in the age group of 18 to 64 years, in those who have received seasonal flu vaccine. Next. Duration of protection, 1 calendar year. Next. Nasal or IM, again this has become another problem. Parents will give the child, doctor, shall I give my child the intranasal vaccine or injectable vaccine? You decide. So you have to tell them what are all the advantages and disadvantages. Below 3 years, you cannot give the intranasal vaccine. And the seroconversion is supposed to be 86 to 92% in nasal and 80 to 90%. They are comparable as far as the seroconversion rates are concerned. Local IgA and cell mediated immunity is supposed to be stimulated with the nasal vaccine. But again,